Today on Topics in Radiography, I'm going to answer one of your questions. And that question was, what happens when the X-ray button is pressed? So really quite a few things are happening right there. The button's pushed down in two phases, if you'll notice. When you first push the button down, there's kind of a stopping point halfway in between, where it takes a little more pressure to push it all the way down. And you'll notice that if you walk up and push the X-ray button down all the way, it's going to take a few seconds for an actual X-ray exposure to come out. There's a bit of a delay, and I'll explain the reason for that. So to really understand what's happening within the tube, you kind of have to know what's happening as you push the button each little step. So as you push it halfway down, that delay is because the anode starts to begin to rotate. That's one thing that happens. The anode needs to rotate to a constant velocity. So really, really fast. The X-ray production produces a lot of heat. So if the anode isn't rotating at a constant speed, more heat will be applied in some locations than others as it's turning. So there's a delay because it has to get to a constant speed before it will allow you to take the exposure. Now, still within that first step, as you're pushing the X-ray button halfway down, you're also boiling off electrons at the cathode, specifically at the filament. The X-ray generator is being supplied with amperage, or electric current, to the filament, which begins to boil off electrons. Now, this is all happening inside a vacuum, so the electrons are just bundling in a cloud. They call it thermionic emission. It's bundling in a cloud right around the filament. So it's just kind of putting out electric current. It's not necessarily going anywhere yet, but it's just sitting there around the filament as the anode's spinning up and getting to the constant speed. Once the speed is constant, that's when you'll get the little notification sound and the light on this particular control panel, letting you know the speed is constant and you can push the X-ray button all the way down to get the exposure. Now, you can push the X-ray button all the way down in one step, but there's going to be a delay between the time you push it and the time the exposure is made. So, especially for exams when breathing is required, you may consider holding it down halfway, briefly, not too long, but halfway until your breathing instructions are given, and then pushing it all the way down once you know the patient's respiration is held. You've pushed the button halfway, the anode's rotating at a constant velocity, and you have your electron cloud filled with electrons from the tube current. Now, once you push it all the way down, the kilovoltage that you set, your potential difference, your electromotive force, gets applied to the electrons, or that tube current, to send it from the cathode straight across to the anode. Once those electrons collide with the tungsten metal of the anode, that's how X-rays are produced. It's the atomic interaction and exchange of energy between those electrons and the metal in the anode. This is going to happen for the exact duration of your exposure time. Once that time has been reached, the voltage and current drop off. There's a switch that opens up that prevents the flow of electricity through the X-ray tube. So in review, push it halfway down, anode accelerates, your electron cloud starts boiling off at the cathode, push it all the way down, kilovoltage is applied, which pushes it to the anode. Electrons get converted into X-ray photons, which spread in every direction, right? But we have a lead housing around the X-ray tube, which only allows the X-rays to come down towards the patient through the collimator box. And that's it. You're going to learn more about the subatomic level of those interactions and the different types of interactions that can occur in your X-ray program. But essentially, that's what happens when you make an X-ray exposure. I hope this answers your question well. If you've enjoyed this content, make sure to hit like down below. And please subscribe if you want more content like this, or if you have any other questions that you'd like to ask me. I'm here. I can answer them. I love doing it. So why not? Hope to see you soon.